some people think confidence, having confidence in yourself, is arrogant. I don't, because I know what I like, and I love music. I don't care what anybody thinks. The reason I'm playing music is because I love it. It's like me getting a divorce from my wife. You know, I didn't marry her to get a divorce. I didn't start in music to quit. The longer you live, the more you learn, you learn, you learn, you learn.
Thank you. My experience with Miles is that he was the best listener who also led a band that I've ever seen.
He would always say, play what you don't know, which means you had to know everything to get back to zero. That was my interpretation of it. But if I look, you listen to Miles and listen to Train, you listen to all them cats, the exploration takes you back to the embryo. You did a whole full life. So 360 is zero. He would always say, I don't want you to play what you know, play what you don't know.
Thank you. Miles knew how to play one note that has Earth time, galactic time, celestial time. One note, you know. So if people misunderstand Miles, it's because they rationalize Miles with their mind, not with their heart. If you see Miles from your heart, he's right on. The most important priority is to arouse your band, not the people. Not the people, 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 people.
Miles had these guys who had been brought up in this jazz tradition, and he had them playing, you know, funk and rock. And you could tell they weren't comfortable with it, or at least I could feel that they weren't comfortable with playing this rock music, but they had so much respect for Miles that they did it anyway, and you can hear the struggle in that music. You can hear these jazz musicians trying to acclimate themselves to this new language with no chord changes and very strict rhythm pulse, you know, and you can tell that they did what they did with Miles because of Miles, because Miles wanted to try it and Miles wanted to push. And they said, well, let's push with Miles.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye. with Miles, it was always when he was available. He said, I want to record. I said, okay, let's do it. What are we going to do? He'd call me up in the middle of the night and say, listen to this. I said, listen to what? He said, listen to this. And he'd play something for 40 minutes on the phone. You get that sheet. I'm sitting there and I'm lying there and I'm listening to Miles Davis at 1, 2 o'clock in the morning with something he had done. And then he'd want to critique.
Bye. magical mystery mix.